And within the university system, no, I must place the unions in proper pathway for this young man.
Hello and welcome to the program. I am Deji Badimasi and we're still talking the National Conference. As we speak, selection of delegates is going on across the country. Do not forget, the federal government has said it expects 492 delegates to attend the conference. So selection is going on across the country by the various groups now that have been cleared to attend that conference. Now, not quite long ago, just early this week now, I should say, the a community of Yoruba leaders met in Ibadan, the Oyo State capital. It's actually called, they call it the Yoruba Constitutional Conference. We have different groups from the Southwest that are meeting, but this group now, made up of several Yoruba leaders, met in Ibadan, the Oyo State capital, and they came up with an agenda they intend to push before that conference. Now, there you have the highlight of the agenda. And those are the issues contained in the communique now released after that meeting. And now those things, those issues you can see right there are the issues or items, I should say, that this group now intends to push at the national conference. And of course, the group says this is the Yoruba agenda. This is the agenda it intends to take to the national conference. Now, not just that, the group intends to organize whether you want to call it a mock, some kind of mock conference where it will meet with, an expanded delegation, now expanded group of Yoruba people just to get their inputs on these various items that have been released. Now, those are the items, regionalism. Basically, what the group is saying is that we should go back to the era. Now, era when we had, back in 1960, when we had the four regions operating, they said they would want to see a weaker center and a powerful region. So we're talking about that's what it says is going to campaign, is going to push for at the conference, is going to push for regionalism. It's also going to push for a parliamentary system of government. And it's also advocating that the various regions now should have their own separate constitution, different from the constitution of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. So it means you would have a constitution for the central government, and the various regions now should have their own constitution. Of course, that is what the group is saying. It also says, that there's nothing wrong at all in discussing the secession, that if any part of the country decides to secede, that, you know, that the provision should be there in the constitution, that the constitution should allow people or any part of the country that chooses to break away. Do not forget, the federal government has made it clear that it is not going to entertain any discussion at all on the disintegration of Nigeria. So I really wonder how this is going to go down with the federal government. Of course, they're also going to talk about resource control and state regional policing. That's policing, actually, not polling. They're going to talk about state and regional policing and, of course, the restructuring of the army. Now, let's go over to something completely different. People have been reacting. People have been making suggestions now as to what they want to see at the conference. As I said, the federal government has said nothing about the disunity or disintegration of this country will be discussed. So that is a no-go area. That's what the federal government has said. But guess what? Some groups, some civil society groups have been asking the federal government to change its mind. As a matter of fact, they're saying everything should be on the table. Everything should be discussed. Take a listen to what some of them are saying.
If we're talking about a national conference, that national conference must have no-go area. We must have proper representatives of the people, the stakeholders, and not even government having to serve as a chunk of a representative. So therefore, a conference that there be no go area is unacceptable. We must have unfettered access into discussing what has led us to lie critically ill at the intensive care units. Again, we must also ensure that whatever it arrived at must be subject to a national referendum of the people of Nigeria. If the people of Nigeria takes the resolution and throw it into the trash can, so be it. It's the people of Nigeria that will subject it to a national referendum. They are the only ones who can tinker with the resolution.
I have been advocate of this Sovereign National Conference, and we spent over a decade clamoring for it. Good thing the government asked for dialogue, but it's not just about calling for the dialogue. There are issues, there are certain indices that we must insist that it comes. That's why some of us felt we don't necessarily have to participate in the conference. Not because we believe in the conference, but let us start somewhere. If a government of the day will call for a conference, believing that something actually went wrong, the unity of the country is being threatened. And to that extent, he said, okay, let's sit down and talk. Let us assume people will sit down and talk. But it's also our responsibility to ensure that those delegates who will go to the conference, we will ensure that we compel them, we will watch them, we will listen and we will advise them from experiences. That beyond sitting at the conference, we must insist, let them go to the conference and insist that the outcome of that conference should not go through the National Assembly, should go through referendum. Because if we go through referendum, that will enable us to address this fraud document we call 1999 Constitution that we are challenging legitimacy.
Now, the issue of a referendum has been a very contentious one. Basically, all the groups that are supposed, ethnic nationalities and various civil society groups that are supposed to be attending this conference are saying first that there should be no no-go areas and that the outcome of the conference should be subjected to a referendum. Of course, that's not what the federal government is thinking. The president has made it clear that the outcome of the conference would be submitted to the National Assembly and that the National Assembly would incorporate it into its constitution amendment process. So it would appear the federal government is thinking something completely different from what most of these groups are thinking. So we really wonder how that will be resolved. But we caught up with a member of the National Dialogue Committee. Don't forget, the president set up a committee. That committee came out with a report, and that report, of course, led to the promulgation or pronouncement that the conference is going to hold later this year. And of course, the president has come out, or the government, I should say, has come out with the number of delegates that will be attending that conference. Now, we caught up with a member of that committee to ask him what he makes of the issue of a referendum and some other issues that are coming up. Take a listen to what he said.
In the committee, our report said, let the National Conference decide whether it wants a referendum. You see, you have to be strategic in thinking and planning. If you say now, for example, oh, we must put a legislation through the National Assembly before the convoking of the conference, that means the conference won't take place this year. I want it to take place. If we say we must have a referendum, that may mean that certain very vital interests in Nigeria will start working hard against the conference. So we're not recommending that there be a referendum or there not be a referendum. Left alone to me and to individuals on the committee, we would have preferred a referendum. But we decided for political and strategic reasons to say let the referendum be decided, or let the National Conference itself decide whether it wants a referendum, whether it wants a brand new constitution, and how it shall go about having it.
Now, that's another point. Whether most of these groups are asking for a new constitution, but of course, that's not what the federal government wants. The federal government has said this will be incorporated into the whole constitution amendment process of the National Assembly. But do you know there are some people who do not at all believe, they do not believe at all in this whole idea of the National Conference, and they have their own reason. Take a listen to what one of them now has been saying about the National Conference and some of the issues that have been raised over it.
The contraption we have today is nothing but a fraud on the Nigerian people. If you remove the government nominees from that conference, they cannot achieve the 75% they say they need to achieve to pass any resolution in that conference. Imagine after setting up the conference and bringing out the modalities, they say 75% is needed to pass any resolution. Knowing fully well that all government nominees, if you remove them, both at federal and state level, once they give them instructions not to back any resolution, nobody can achieve 75% in that conference. And then the president is telling you that the conference should advise him as to what to do with the report. I mean, is that not funny? Government says, when you finish deliberation, advise me on how to incorporate your decision into the constitution. How can we advise you? How can Nigerians advise you on what is a clear constitutional matter? To amend the constitution is a constitutional matter. So how will they advise you on how to incorporate the decision? In other words, you have no idea as to what you want to do with the report. They are the ones to advise you as to what to do with the report. So people should understand that they are embarking on a journey to nowhere. It's a journey to nowhere. And I am surprised that even certain long-time comrades of ours are supporting this idea. I am surprised that they have been hoodwinked this time around.
Well, a journey to nowhere. Festus Keyamo, their human rights lawyer. We'll take a short break now. When we come back, we'll go one-on-one with one man who has for long been advocating a national conference, but this time a sovereign national conference. We'll find out what he makes of the government-proposed national conference. Stay with us. Every day, every hour, and every minute, news break in Nigeria. Things happen so fast, it's most times difficult to track and comprehend them. But that's what we do right here on DEJI360. 2015, would you want to come back again?
It's like asking Jesus Christ if he knew he was going to die, will you come? Will you want to come back as the savior of the world again?
We do not just help you track the stories, we break them down, explore all the angles, analyze the issues so that you can fully comprehend the stories and use them to make the right decisions. Welcome back. Now, Wale Okuni used to be the spokesperson of PRONACO, that's the Pro-National Conference Organization. Of course, the group held its own conference some years ago and came out with its own draft document. And that document, unfortunately, has still not become the constitution of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. Now the federal government has accepted to hold a national conference, of course, short of the sovereign national conference PRONACO called for. I sat down with Wale Okuni now to find out what he makes of the government's plan to hold this conference and whether he thinks the conference will result in anything at all. Now, he joined me in the studio earlier in the week.
Well, that's true that we are a bit excited that the president has initiated the move for a national conference, which of course we feel will be constitutional and political. It must be well defined, and these are the issues that have been contended at this point, whether it's going to give birth to a new constitution or whether it will also help us with political negotiation of the country.
You're quite right, because it would appear the president is thinking of something completely different from what you people are thinking. You people have always said you want a new constitution and that you would want a new constitution to come out of this process. But the president is simply looking at a constitution amendment process, because he's clearly said that the outcome of the conference will be handed over to the National Assembly to incorporate it into its ongoing constitution amendment process. So clearly two different things that we're looking at here.
Not really. The new modality release did not show that the president has expressly said that.
Well, the president said so sometimes.
Sometimes, but there is a new modality, which of course was evasive, a bit vague about what will happen. They said that the conference will decide what will happen with the resolution. So it is now left to the conference to decide whether it wants to be use the raw material of the resolution as part of amendment process, or whether it wants to turn it into something that will be legislated as a new constitution. So that also will be clarified, you know, in days to come.
I have to ask you this. First, there's no legal framework setting up this conference as we speak today. There's no act has been, you know, no bill at all, or no act has been made by the National Assembly now setting up the national conference. So if you don't have that in place, there's no law establishing it. This has just been established by the pronouncement of the president. How then do you think the outcome of this conference could have some kind of legal basis?
Well, some experts have posited that the president has power under Section 5 to bring about a national conference.
But does it become a law?
Well, not necessarily.
Because that doesn't make it an act of parliament.
The resolution of the conference will still have to, one way or the other, be passed to the National Assembly, I suppose, one way, but not to tamper with it, because it's the sovereign will of the Nigerian people, who are the owners of the country, who are expected to be.
There's something I want to really understand about this issue of, the conference being the sovereign will of the Nigerian people. Let's look at it this way. This national conference, you have 492 delegates who are going there. Most of these delegates are not going to be elected. They'll just be selected. As a matter of fact, the president is appointing quite a substantial number, about 40-something. The governors will be appointing. The political parties will be making appointments as well. I mean, these are representatives chosen or selected. And then you go to the National Assembly, where you have, for instance, in the House of Representatives, you have 360 elected members of the House. You go to the Senate, you have 109 elected senators. How then would you say these people who are chosen, basically chosen to attend this conference, would be regarded as representing the sovereign will of the people, and you wouldn't consider lawmakers who are elected as also representing the sovereign will of the people?
The selection process itself will be profound if for this can be made profound. You don't necessarily, well, the ethnic nationalities, for instance, because we are still contending with the slots of delegate from the ethnic nationalities.
Yes.
If you allow that to be enlarged, then they'll find a way to select or elect or choose. And then if you have overwhelming majority of those original indigenous group in that conference, then you have a legitimate
Let's not also forget that selection process is going on as we speak.
Oh yes, it should be. It should be ongoing now. People are consulting. But then government should really begin to also, there is need for a body. Consultation can be on, but the secretariat, the commission to drive it must also direct and guide the consultation that gives back to emergence of participant or delegate. If they don't do that, then you may have problem. There must be guidelines. So I expect that the secretariat of the national conference should be working by now to guide and to interface with the various constituents they are expected to select.
Even though the secretariat has not been set up anyway. But are you not disappointed that your group, PRONACO, is not, you were not invited to send in delegates to this conference? I mean, PRONACO as a group.
As a group. Yes. Well, that's part of the shortcomings.
Especially when you consider what you have done in this regard, that your organization has been in the forefront of pushing or calling for a national conference.
Yeah, you are right. And that's part of the initial intervention we have made. We have spoken to those who are in charge, and we have told them that, look, we have reservation about the composition. We have reservation about the slot given to some constituency, particularly the ethnic and the civil society. PRONACO specifically should have been invited. Well, we don't want to push for anything here. We know what we have done here. We know that we can only add value to the conference because we have done it practically. And the two, we also have done researches in trying to help this. But then it is the wisdom of government to go that way. We will engage them. We further engage government and see whether we can have some amendment in what has been set put out as modalities.
Would I be right to say this conference is not a people's conference? It's a government's conference.
Well, I don't want to say that. This is driven
quite
by government.
The kind of conference you
can still, the people can still hone this. Government has set the template. I feel that if government,
because in this case we're having a situation where the government, as you said, has set the template. Government has decided on the number of people to attend. Government has decided on how to distribute representation now to that conference. So basically, and government has also said, well, there are certain areas you can't discuss, for instance.
Yes, I think all this we consider as proposals from government. And that's why we have decided to engage further, to see whether we can change some, amend some.
When you say you consider as proposal, already, I'm saying selection is already going on to choose delegates to attend this conference. There isn't time at all. The conference is beginning in March, and this is February.
No, we can still. I mean, we can still change. We can still do a lot of things between now and March. I don't want government to be fixated on what it has done. We consider it as proposal. We talk to government on how it can be best done so that the people can hone the conference. If the people of Nigeria, particularly the indigenous people, do not hone it, it will be a huge waste of resources and time. It will not lead anywhere. So we want a situation whereby the Nigerian people can hone this process. This process can be driven by them. And to do that, we need a modality and framework that is truly people's, you know, oriented or people's driven. So therefore, we will continue to engage within the short time that we have before the conference to talk to them about, well, some of the slots for delegates in areas we feel they should do something about. We should also, about how to drive this. It's not enough for you to say civil society, but how will they select? Yes,
we
have been talking to even the civil slot given to civil society is inadequate. It's inadequate, but within this way, we are setting up parameters for those that will be there. One of them is that you must have canvas or advance constitutional and political question in Nigeria. You must come. You must have knowledge of the issues which has to do with Nigeria. You must again. The selection itself must have geopolitical spread and gender mainstreaming. You know, but then we find what has been given to civil society inadequate. We find the slot given to ethnic, so that you don't have a government conference at the end of the day. And that's why I said to you that we didn't want to call it a government conference because we think we can still improve on the proposal, in which case you bring more ethnic nationality groups into it or ethnic nationalities to have more slot, maybe 300 or whatever, doesn't matter. And the time is short anyway, they have said tentative. It means that the conference on its own can...
There isn't much time. Elections is also...
Then, yes, election will be in February. You can see spend 9 months to do that and come out with outcome. You can spend 6 months.
And spending so much time is spending so much money.
No, because it's not a talk show. It's a conference of the Nigerian people to negotiate their existence. It's not something that can be... If you do that, you have wasted resources. You have wasted time because you wouldn't have negotiated all the crises. And for us, the National Conference is a conflict management mechanism.
And talking about negotiation now, I have to ask.
It is.
Let me just ask you this. Don't you think primordial sentiments will come to play during the actual talk and negotiation itself, when issues are thrown up for the entire House to discuss, that primordial ethnic sentiments will come to play, and that could make it difficult for this conference to be able to reach an agreement on some very contentious issues? You know, for instance, even have that 75% majority, it might not be so easy. Because, I mean, we're talking about a country where the mistrust is so high, the regions do not trust themselves at all, and people are coming to this conference with these sentiments and all of that. And these sentiments are definitely going to guide the way they make their decisions on certain things.
Sentiment or no sentiment, the people will have to negotiate their collective existence. They will have to throw some things aside. They will have to take something. It has to be give and take. There will also be disagreement. There will be issues that will be so contentious that the chairman will need to devour and say, look, can we move forward with another issue, etc. So that's why you need time to do this. This is nation building. This is building Nigeria afresh, building a new Nigeria. This is resolving the conflict, because you must discuss to a point that is really explosive. But then, at the end of the day, it is the management capacity of the leadership of the conference that will determine the success. So you also need people of impeccable or unimpeachable integrity to manage this. People who understand the issues, not somebody who is a partisan who is seen as a lucky or political jobber for Mr. President.
But there are still difficulties ahead.
You know, so we will be able to, at the end of the day, we have had national conferences here and there around the world. We need to study them. But our own here must come out with it. Otherwise, it will be a waste. You want to go and put a people's resolution into one amendment of Decree 24, foisted by military, that will not be logical.
Well, okay.
So I think that we really need to hone what the government has set us as proposal. If they say it's fixated, fine. We will leave them, but we'll come back to Swahiban. So we are saying that what government has pushed out as modalities should be considered as proposal. and let the people engage it. We should not act as military government. He said, obey and come. No. You have said this is it. Let the people discuss it. That is the beginning of the national conference.
Wale Okuni, spokesperson of ProNACO there. Now, that's it on the program. If you want to watch it again, it's simple. Just go to our website, tv360nigeria.com. You'll find the program and lots more there. You can also watch us on YouTube by subscribing to our YouTube channel. It is youtube.com/tv360nigeria. Follow us on Google Plus at tv360nigeria. And you could like us on Facebook. The address is facebook.com/tv360online. You can also follow us on Twitter. Our handle is at TV360 online. Thank you very much for watching. I'm DEJI360. I'll see you next week.